Welcome back. In this lesson, I'm going to compare cloud computing to what we often call traditional IT, sometimes also known as legacy IT. And what I mean by that is the operating model that we used before cloud computing. And many organizations are still using that model today. Many are using that as well as cloud computing. But what I want to do now is just talk a bit about that operating model and just to set the scene as to how it looks and what some of the challenges are with that operating model, so that we can then see what the benefits are of the cloud. So in the traditional IT operating model, companies will often have a corporate data center. Now, you may actually own this data center outright, or you may lease some space in somebody else's data center, also known as a co-location facility. And within that data center, you'll likely have lots of racks, just like we have in this graphic here. And those racks will then contain the servers, the storage systems, routers, switches, firewalls, backup systems, and many, many more devices. Your company will very likely own this infrastructure, all these systems within the data center. In some cases, and the reason I've got an asterisk there, is you might actually lease this from another company, but in many cases, organizations will actually own this infrastructure outright, and then they'll depreciate it over a period of time. So this model is very capital expensive. You need lots of cash to actually purchase all these systems. Now, when you're connecting in, typically you'll do so over a link from your corporate office. And then in your office, you'll have your staff. And the key thing to note here is that in this operating model, it's very labor intensive. So your IT staff need to design, build, operate, and manage all of this equipment. So what are the costs of this particular model? Well, we have the data center building itself, whether you're actually owning that or whether you're leasing some space in a data center, it can still be very expensive. Data center security, especially if you own your own data center, the staffing costs for the security and the systems that you're going to need to use can also be very expensive. Then there's the physical IT hardware that you've purchased. There's software licensing costs, maintenance contracts, power, and internet connectivity. And then you've got the staff wages, design, build, operations, and maintenance. So lots and lots of costs. Now, it's not that all of these go away in the cloud, but quite a few of them do. So let's just compare side by side cloud computing to the traditional IT operating model. So with cloud computing, remember, we have on-demand self-service. With traditional IT, there's usually human involvement required. So if, for example, a developer wants to provision a new server to run some kind of development application, he may have to go to a human being, so he might have to call somebody, maybe it's an email, or maybe it's a form that then goes to someone for an approval. So normally there'll be some kind of approval process that could be automated, but it will often require at least steps involved where there's humans. So that can be slow and it can be inefficient. Broad network access. So remember, this means that you can access your service from any connection and anywhere at any time as well. With traditional IT, you can certainly make your resources available, and obviously companies do make sure that they publish certain resources on the internet to make them available to their customers or to their staff when their staff are working from home or working on the road. But there's typically internal accessibility primarily and a limited public presence, and it's a bit more difficult to publish those services on the internet. Conversely, with cloud computing, you have APIs, which we'll talk about later in the course, which means that you can access pretty much any service over the internet. We have resource pooling with cloud computing, so that means large amounts of capacity are put together and pooled so that they can then be offered to different customers who share that underlying infrastructure. With traditional IT, it's typically single tenant, so your organization owns the infrastructure and uses it. Now, sometimes it can be multi-tenant if you have different departments and you actually implement a private cloud, which we'll talk about again later in this section. But for the most part, it's going to be a single set of infrastructure for your company, and you may virtualize that to get some additional efficiency gains and other benefits. Cloud computing offers rapid elasticity. So remember, that means that you can scale to huge amounts. So if your website suddenly needs a vast amount of resources for a mega event that you're hosting, then in the public cloud, you don't really have to worry too much about that infrastructure being available. In the traditional IT operating model, you often have limited scalability, so you're actually constrained by the infrastructure you have in your data center. So for instance, if you suddenly need a large amount of capacity and you check how much you've got available and you don't have it, then unfortunately you're kind of stuck. So you would have to purchase those systems, and then there might be a long lead time. It could take weeks, could take months before you have them ordered, installed, and operating and running. In the cloud, you could do it straight away. So you could literally just the next day, if you needed to, you'd be able to run that event. In the cloud, we have measured service. So remember, this is your itemized billing. So you can see what you're using, what the rate is, and then how much you're getting charged. In a traditional IT operating model, usage is typically not measured. Now, you might have some kind of metering software, but it's not that often the case. And therefore, if you wanted to attribute costs, for example, to a specific department, it can be quite difficult to do that. That's all I wanted to cover in this lesson. Hopefully now you have a bit of an understanding of what cloud computing is, what defines it, and some of the benefits and how they compare to traditional IT. So I hope you enjoyed that lesson. I'll see you in the next one.